Hello, my name is Professor Rob McClung, and I'd like to talk with you about Biology 11. The biology curriculum is designed such that you can enter it from a number of vantage points. For example, your first biology class could be Biology 2, Human Biology, or could be one of the Biology 11 offerings, or could be any one of the five foundation courses, Biologies 12 through 16. A number of these courses are offered in the fall, for example, all Biology 2, 11, as well as three of the foundation courses. In addition, Biology 11 and foundation courses are offered in each of the winter and spring terms. So how do you choose? Well, what is Biology 11? Biology 11 is a topics-based introductory biology course. In 2015-16, it will be offered each term, although each term will be different and organized around a different topic and taught by different faculty. Each offering is designed to provide a synthetic overview of biology and to introduce fundamental ideas, processes, and theories in biology. All the offerings will cover key principles and concepts in biology. So, for example, we'll be talking about cell biology, molecular biology, genetics, evolution, energetics. The specific details, however, that you learn about each of these will vary from course to course, from offering to offering. This is deliberate because we wish to emphasize process, learning to think biologically, over any specific content. Now, what are the objectives of Biology 11? First and foremost is to stimulate your interest in biology, and so we've chosen topics that highlight how biological thought is broadly and globally important. Second, we want to encourage and help you develop critical, analytical, scientific thinking and skills. We want to communicate key concepts in biology. We also want you to develop an appreciation for this specific topic that's the subject of the offering that you choose. And finally, although this isn't really a global objective, it might be one of your objectives, I want to point out to you that if it's the first biology class that you've taken, Biology 11 will count towards your biology major. There are three offerings this year. In the fall, DNA to Diversity, taught by Professors Jack and Peart. In the winter, Emerging Infectious Diseases, How Microbes Rule the World, taught by Professor Garineau and by myself. And in the spring, Major Events in the History of Life in the Human Genome, taught by Professor Peterson. For more information on each of these specific offerings, I encourage you to take a look at the videos that have been made by Professors Jack, Garineau, and Peterson. How would you decide between Biology 11 and a foundation course? Well, first, think about subject matter. Choose a course that is of high intellectual interest to you. The best way to do well in your courses is to be interested in them and pick a topic that's interesting. Second, you might want to consider workload. Both Biology 11 and each of the foundation courses are rigorous, high-intensity courses. However, they're distinguished in that the foundation courses each have a laboratory component. Therefore, this means that there is an increased workload, and so you might want to bear that in mind in consideration of which course is appropriate for you. Finally, probability of scholastic success. Biology 11, by not having a laboratory course, simply will permit you more time to focus on the materials covered in lecture. To further help you decide which course is the appropriate choice for you, we offer a placement advisory test. It's an hour-long test. It consists of 30 multiple-choice questions. The results are advisory, not binding, and it's available under courses. For more information about this advisory placement test, you can see a video by Professor Thomas Jack. So that's what I have to tell you now about Biology 11, and I hope to see many of you in the winter offering.